Hello everyone, continuing with our discussion on the intermediate code generation, we're going to see some of the examples of the intermediate codes using the three address codes. For example, the expression is given minus a plus b multiplied with c plus d plus a plus b plus c. Fine, so we have to convert this expression into the three address code. So let us first represent this a plus b with this temporary variable t1. And then let's say t2 equals to minus t1. This is the unary operation. Let's say this is the second operation we are doing. And the third one, to represent the c plus d in some temporary variable, let's say t3. And then this a plus b into, let's say, some t4. Okay, or before this, what we can do? Yes, obviously. Before this, because this addition is being performed, will be performed later. So what we are going to do, we are actually multiplying this t2 and t3. This is t2 and this is t1 and this is t2. Fine, this is t1 and this is t2, and then minus t1 is t2. So, and this one is t3. So, we have to multiply this t2 and t3. So, this t2 and t3 will be stored in t4. Having done that, we're going to find out this a plus b again. So, this is found in, let's say, some temporary variable t5. And then, in some t6, we're going to add this t5 plus c. So, t5 plus c. And then finally we're going to we already have this t4 multiplication of these two are stored in the t4, and then this is the t6, so we're going to add this t4 and t6 and going to store that in t7. So this is how we can represent this three address code. We can use any number of the temporary variable as per our convenience. Now these three address codes can be represented in the various forms. So what are the various ways or the three address code can be represented? There are three different ways by which these can be represented. One is the quadruple, the other one is triples, and the third one is indirect triple. So these are the three different ways by which these three address codes can be represented. So now we are going to take we are going to see all these things one by one. So the intermediate code or the code remains the same. It is just that we have to understand how these things are going to be represented. So quadruples, as the name suggests, that it will have the four elements. Okay, so it will have four elements. So just see the example of this one, how the quadruples are represented. So just see that if we have to represent this a plus b. Okay. And this has to be represented in T1. So in this table, we are going to have the four elements. First element is the operator, second is operand, third is operand, and the final one is the result. So here we have a plus b, and operation is plus, and the result is stored in T1. So T1 equals to a plus b. T1 equals to a plus b, which was actually required to be stored, is being restored like this. You can say this, we had to store t1 equals to a plus b. So first one is the operation plus a, b as the operands, operand 1 and operand 2, and t1 is the result. Similarly, in this one, t2 equals to minus t1. So in this, we have only one operand associated with the operator. So minus is the operation, which is the negation. With this, only one operand is associated, that is t1. There is no second operation, so dash, and then T2 is the place where we are going to store the result. third operation is T3 equals to C plus D. So what you're going to use this plus operation, C and D are the operands, and the result is stored in T3. Fine. And then the next operation is T4 equals to T2 multiplied with T3. T4 equals to T2 multiplied with T3. So multiplication is the operation, T2 is the operand, T3 is the operand, and the result is stored in T4. Fifth operation is T5 equals to A plus B. So here the plus is the operation, A and B are the operands, and T5 is the result. Next operation is T6 equals to T5 plus C. So sixth operation, plus is the operation, T5 is the operand, C is the operand, and result is stored in T6. And then this T7 is equals to T4 plus T6, which is the final answer. So plus is the operation, T4 and T7, T6 are the operands, and the result is stored in T7. So this is the quadruple. Fine. So we will see its advantage and the disadvantage later. But just to go, we are looking at the next method by which these three underscores can be represented, that is the triples. So now the triple will have only three fields. Earlier we had four fields in the four elements in the quadruples. In the triple we will have three elements. Okay, and now the steps are actually mentioned here in the triples. In the triples we are actually mentioning the steps. Fine. Now you just see the three elements are operation, operand 1 and operand 2. For example, here T1 equals to A plus B. For this we have represented it like plus A and B. We are not actually representing this T1. The step number 1 itself meaning that this is the temporary variable T1. And then this second operation is T2 equals to minus T1. So whatever operation we have done in this first step, if we negate that, that becomes the T2. So under bracket or the under the parenthesis we have written this 1, meaning that this is the result, this is showing the result of the first operation, and the negation operation is applied before that. Second, or there is no second operation. In the third, we have to add these two, C and D. So T3 equals to C plus D. This is the operation, T3, third operation is T3 equals to C plus D. So C and D are the operands and plus is the operator. This is done in the third step. In the fourth step, we are going to multiply this. T4 equals to T2 multiplied with T3. So T2 is found in the second step, T3 is found in the third step, and we are going to multiply these two and going to store in T4. So what is happening here? The result in second operation, result in third operation is multiplied, and this is the answer in the fourth iteration or fourth step. Sorry. The fifth step is T5 equals to A plus B. So the fifth step is plus is the operation, A and B are the operands, and the result is stored in the fifth stage. Then the sixth one is T6 equals to T5 plus C. So we will have to refer to the fifth step, T5. So for that, in the sixth step, you have to refer to the answer found in the fifth step, that is added with the C, plus is the operation. In the seventh step, finally what we are going to do, T7 equals to T4 plus T6. So whatever answer we have found in the fourth step is added with the result found in the sixth step. So plus operation, fourth and sixth. Whatever result was found in fourth, whatever the result was found in sixth, we have added these two. So you can see that there is a dependency on the previous steps. Okay, so these operations which are being done in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 steps cannot be moved around. They cannot be moved up or moved down. Okay, but here in the quadruples, you can see that in the quadruples, these statements can be moved around because we are storing the result in some temporary variable, and those temporary variables are unique. So either that is T1 or T2 or T3. Even if we are swapping those statements, one first statement, second statement, third statement, it does not matter because the result is stored in the temporary variable and we are concerned with the temporary variables only. But the disadvantage of the quadruple is that it is taking so much space. It is taking four columns. Okay, so we can save one of the column in the triple. Okay, here we are using only three columns. So space is not wasted, but here in the triple we cannot move around the statements. The statements have to remain the same. we cannot move around the statement because there is a dependency. In the second step, the first answer in the first step is use. We cannot swap this first and the second statement. There will be highly, they are actually highly dependent on each other, the statements. Right? Another way to represent this is the indirect ripple. Indirect ripple means it is actually going to use the pointer to the instructions. Fine. So what we will say that we will store the triple program in the memory, and while the execution we will provide the sequence of the statements or sequence of the execution of the statements. For example, here what we are saying that we have these statements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then we can provide the address of the instruction 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and this actually is the sequence. So here again, what can be done, that the statements can be moved. If you have to run the sixth statement first, then we'll write six first and fourth later, then fourth can be written later. So statements can be moved. Okay. Now what is happening here in this indirect triple? So once you are actually referring to this statement number one, let's say we are referring to the statement number one here in the triple, and then we have to do these operation also. So here we are using the two memory accesses. Okay, one is the access for this one and the other one is the pointer. So this will be giving the address to the statement where actually these three address code is stored. So this will be using the two memory accesses. So this is actually the disadvantage, but yes, the advantage is that we can move around the instructions. Right. Thank you.